ladies. So I'm really, really excited for this video because I have a lot to talk about. First off, I'll start off by saying congratulations to me. No, I'm just kidding. Thank you so much, teeny tiny treasures. She did a giveaway a couple weeks ago. I don't remember exactly when it was, but she was giving away 3 items of your choice for whoever the winner was. And I was sitting watching her video, and I was like really like excited because I had a few people in mind that I, you know, was really hoping would win it. And so I was like ready to write congratulations to whoever. And she did the random.org, and she scrolled down on her little list, and she was like, pocket full of hopes. I'm like, that's me. Like, oh my God, I've never won anything ever in my entire life. I don't win anything. I have like the worst luck. Like, I'm not even kidding when I say that. So I already knew like a few things that I had in mind that I wanted to get and that I wanted to do. So the first thing I got was this little black hair piece, which you probably can't see it really well, and because I'm using my webcam, so I don't know, I'll try to like make this brighter or whatever, see if I can make it any better, but it's really cute. It's on her website, but I love hair pieces, and I just thought it was so pretty, and I have a white one, like a white flower already, so I didn't want to get the white one, even though it was very tempting because it was really cute, but I already have a white one, so I went ahead and got the black one. And then one of the other things was her keychains, and her bracelets are my absolutely favorite of like all the stuff that she has. And I really wanted a bracelet, but I'm a very terrible person when it comes to losing stuff. Like, I lose stuff so easily. So I was scared to get the bracelet and be at work and one of the kids like pull on it or something, or I lose it. You know, my wrist is so tiny. I'm sure even the small would not fit my wrist to the way that it needs to. So I would be scared to lose it or break it or anything. So I decided to get a keychain instead. And the one I wanted to get, obviously, was her We're Expecting one. I think it is absolutely adorable and beautiful. And I was just excited to get all this stuff. So I don't know how well the camera's going to pick it up, but this is what the keychain looks like. And it's got these little footprints right here. I think these are so adorable. And then this little carriage, I don't know what it's called, but she's got pink and blue and then these beautiful little diamonds. I think this is just gorgeous. I love it. It'll almost be pretty as earrings. Oh yeah, I could wear it as earrings. Get another one. People will be like, oh, cute earrings. I'll be like, thanks. It means I'm expecting. I'm just kidding. So I just thought it was absolutely beautiful. And yeah, I'm like trying. I don't put it on my keys because I'm scared like my keys are going to bang up against it. And I've broke so many of my keychains. So I take this and hook it on my purse because I have this little like hook thing. And it dangles right in the front of my purse. And so it looks really cute. It really, like, my purse is like a cream color, so this accents on it really pretty. And then the third thing I picked out was actually not for me, and it's the whole point of this video. So for some time now, I guess really since about week 5 of my pregnancy, I kind of feel like I've lost touch with so many of the women who are still trying to conceive. And I feel like sometimes when I was still, you know, TTCing, I don't know, I felt like when somebody would get pregnant, they would kind of like forget about us, even though they'd be like, you know, oh, you know, how's everything going for you? Occasionally, you know, maybe they'd check up on me or something, but you know, it just kind of feels like sometimes when someone gets pregnant, you feel like they completely forget about you. And I don't want you guys to feel that way because I still think about you guys all the time. And, you know, you guys are always in my prayers and my thoughts. And, I mean, I would never forget about you guys. I know how it feels to kind of feel, like, neglected or whatever because, like, all the pregnant people now are, like, in this kind of, like, clique almost. And it's, like, we're always talking about pregnancy things and blah, blah, blah. And it's, like, you almost feel like you don't really have that connection anymore with the people who are trying to conceive because they don't understand, you know, the pregnancy talk, obviously, because they're not pregnant, and we can't still relate. I almost feel like I can't relate with you guys anymore, even though, you know, it took us 2.5 years and 2 IUIs, you know, it just almost feels like a lost connection, and I don't want it to be that way at all. So I kind of wanted to do something special for you guys, for those that are trying to conceive still. I kind of just wanted to give a little, like, message slash word of advice. I know some of you have been trying much, much longer than I have. Maybe you have been through miscarriages, or you've been through something worse, you know, I don't know, ectopics or whatever, or they've diagnosed you with PCOS or whatever. You know, I haven't experienced any of that. I don't know what it's like, but I want you to know that I do know what it's like to have that desire and that almost that scaredness of what if I never have a baby. And I will tell you guys, my first IUI after that, it was very difficult. I got this thought in my head, I'm never going to have kids, I'm never going to have a baby by me, it's going to have to be adoption or whatever. And so when I went into my second IUI, I kind of just went into it thinking, whatever, this is going to be another flop, you know, it's wasting my money, I don't know what I'm going to do, I can't afford to keep doing this over and over and over. So when I actually found out that I was pregnant, it was seriously a complete shock. Like, I just was completely surprised. But I feel like in that moment of before, you know, I got pregnant or found out that I was pregnant, and the time of my last IUI, I just lost all hope. You know, it just kind of just, I felt like my knees buckled beneath me, and I had nothing left to look forward to, you know? It's like everything that I had left hanging on to was just completely gone. And I know what it's like to struggle with those thoughts. I know what it's like to wonder, is this ever going to happen to me? For me, nobody knew what was wrong with me. So that in itself was the scariest thing to ever have to go through. And that's why I said I just felt like I would never have kids, because they didn't know what was wrong with me. They didn't know why I couldn't get pregnant. And I would much rather them say, oh, you have this, or this is what's wrong with you, rather than, well, we don't know what's wrong with you. So I just want you guys to know that I pray for you guys, that you still have that little ounce of hope to get you through each month. I know how hard it is. I know how devastating it is to see that negative test, or, you know, to know, oh, I didn't ovulate this month, medicine didn't work, or, you know, whatever, something fell apart at this point and we had to stop. And I know what it's like to go through those things, and I just don't want you guys to ever lose that hope like I did, because I feel like when you get to that point, you kind of just give up almost. Just think about last month, the month, I should say, not last month, the month when I found out that I wasn't pregnant from the first IUI, I wanted to give up. And had I given up, I wouldn't be where I'm at right now. I wouldn't have a baby in my belly right now. I wouldn't be preparing to be a mother. And I can't tell you how many times I wanted to give up, how many times I wanted to just say, you know what, screw this, I'm done with this, I don't want to do it anymore, just let's forget about it. But giving up isn't going to get you anywhere. It's never going to get you anywhere in life. It's just going to keep you in the same spot. Granted, it seems like what you're doing is not getting anywhere, but you never know. It's that one time when it does work, and you will be completely surprised like I was. Anyways, so that was like a really long like intro to my giveaway. But the last thing that I picked out from Teeny Tiny Treasures was a keychain. And I didn't want to get baby dust because I feel like, I feel like baby dust is something that everybody says and it's just kind of like become like a coined phrase kind of thing. But I want you guys to know that I think much, much more of you guys than just, oh, baby dust, you know? I actually want you guys to not just have that 1 month. I want you to have your whole life of fertility. I don't want it just to be, you know, you get pregnant on this time and then it's back to infertility if you have another child. So the reason why I picked out this keychain is because it means ultimate fertility. And it just seemed so much more special to say, I want you to have this and have ultimate fertility and you will have a baby. I don't know how long it's going to take. I don't know if there's a plan for your life that this is the reason why you haven't been able to conceive yet. You know, I kind of had a eye-opener experience as to why I think it took me so long as far as spiritually. I know some of you guys are probably not spiritually, but as far as why I think God wanted me to wait for 2.5 years. As hard as it was, I understand now. So this is what the keychain looks like, and it's going to be really hard to see, so I'm going to post pictures at the end. But it just has these really beautiful just charms and beads, and it's got this little turtle on here. I think that's just absolutely adorable. And then it has this keychain that says, charm that says love. And it just kind of represented how I feel about you guys. I'd have never met you guys. I mean, this is about the most connection most of us are going to get is here on Facebook. But I have a special place in my heart for all of you ladies because I've been there. I know what it's like. I know how hard it is. And I will forever have a special place in my heart for women who have fertility problems. And I just want you to know that I want to be able to give this to somebody in a blessing way of hoping that this is going to bring you some love and support and kind of restore that hope. Because I'm sure some of you are kind of at your wit's end and you're ready to just lose it all and just give up and your hope is shattered like mine was. But I don't want you guys to ever get to that point. So I want this to be kind of that resemblance of, you know, that last little bit of hope. So in lieu of that, as far as the rules for this, I really don't care if you're subscribed to me. I don't really care if you don't, you know, watch my videos all the time or you never comment. I don't care if you, you know, don't have me on Facebook or, you know, you're just coming across this video and you want to enter. You know, I want you guys to have the opportunity to have this little bit of hope shared with you from me and Teeny Tiny Treasures. So this is what it's going to come in. It has her card here. I'm going to give you guys that. So that in case you ever want anything else from her website, which I'll post below in the information, you guys can go and check out her other stuff. But, yeah. So as far as entering, just comment, you know. If you want to comment how you feel, you know, what you've been through, what you've been experiencing, how you've been, you know, feeling lately, you can comment that. Or if you just want to say, please enter me, I'm still trying to conceive, that's fine. That's all I want you to do. And I feel like the winner is going to be the person that needs it the most, you know? I don't know. I'm a very spiritual person, so I believe in God, and I believe that God has a reason and a plan for everything, and that the specific person that this goes to is going to be someone who really needs it. But anyways, that's the end of this video. I know it was really long and I was rambling on a bit, but I just really had that on my heart for like weeks now, and I've been waiting to kind of do a contest, or I don't want to say contest, but giveaway. We'll put it at that, giveaway. I've been wanting to do a giveaway for a little while now, and I've hit over 300 subscribers, so I just want to thank you guys so, so much. I never, ever thought that I would get to that point, just me, little old me, on here doing what I'm doing now, talking to a camera. It's just, you guys are really supportive, and I am just appreciative of each and every one of you guys, and yeah. So I hope you guys will enter, and good luck to all of you guys out there. Just know that I'm still here thinking about you, praying for you, and I just care for you guys so much, and I just wanted you to know that. So anyways, I will chit-chat with you guys later, and yeah, have a good one. Bye.